Joseph Simonetta, who is the head of the New Jersey Hotel and Lodging Association, said, hold on a minute. They're acting like hotels. They ought to be taxed like hotels. Joe, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Appreciate you calling in. Morning, Joe.
Welcome. Hi, how you doing?
Good. How are you? So what do you think?
Thank you for, thanks for letting me add a little depth to the issue and the conversation.
Sure.
We are not opposed to Airbnb. We think entrepreneurship is the right way to go. There's a segment of the population that enjoys staying in private homes. However, as you indicate, regulations are massive, and they have costs. Taxes are massive, and they have costs. And all the hotel association is looking for is parity. If you're going to act like a hotel, you should be under the same rules and regulations and financial obligations that anybody who rents a room on a transient basis is. No one would be happier than us if the regulations were reduced and the taxes were reduced and every municipality could cut their own deal with the hotels that are in their municipality. But if you're going to compete, you should be able and have to compete on parity.
You know, Joe, let me ask you, Joe, first of all, so you raise a good point, and on that, we absolutely have common ground. I completely agree with you that the municipalities should be able to cut their own deals. You know, it empowers the people that are being elected. That's what you want. Otherwise, most of these elected officials come in and they're saddled with all this regulation and all this bureaucracy that they then have to react to, which hurts everybody. Here's the question I have for you, honest question. And on this, I don't know that we're going to agree, but I do want your perspective. How do you see it as they're on par with a hotel? I mean, a hotel has a staff and a maid service, and there's, you know, towels and linens, and there's a lobby, and sometimes there's a pool. And I mean, it's open to the public and you can show up at any time. I see that as very different. Like, it's like the difference between staying in an Atlantic City hotel and renting a house at the shore. I see them as completely different.
And you're right. Single family rentals at the shore are not considered a hotel operation. There's a statute on the books that defines what a transient rental is. Airbnb fits that description. And if it fits that description, it is in direct competition with other properties that represent on a transient basis. I'm not saying Airbnb should not be in existence. I'm not saying Uber should not be in existence. But when you put these things next to a situation that has costs because they are regulated by government and taxed by government, the competitive edge that these properties offer or these businesses offer is to avoid government regulation and taxes.
Right.
That's all well and good, but that should be on a parity level with everybody else that's doing the same service.
So are you going to sue?
This is not my area of expertise. The National Hotel and Lodging Association is already in conversations with Airbnb and also the Federal Trade Commission.
Okay.
What Jersey City has done is, and I do, I agree. I commend Mayor Fulop for grabbing at least some of the money that's laying on the table by not paying any tax.
Yeah, exactly, because it was zero before. All right, Joseph Simonetta, thank you for calling New Jersey 101.5. He is the Executive Vice President of the New Jersey Hotel and Lodging Association. Joe, I really appreciate you calling and exchanging in a conversation about this. I know we don't agree on 100%, but you've got a very reasoned argument, and I think it was important for everyone to hear. We'll be talking soon as this develops.